I always like to play that for my tender friend who has put on a couple of pounds, and she know how I feel about women. I've, in the last 39 years, I've had 5 different women only. And you put them all 5 together on the scales at once, and it would not go past 501 pounds. Don't need no big fat women in my business. And speaking of business, here's the business end of doing somebody wrong.
Frank and Johnny were lovers, old and how they could love. Lord, Lord, for to be true to each other, true in the stars above. He was a man, but he done her. Frank and Johnny went walking. John had on a brand new suit. Lord, Lord, take a step to a neighbor. Don't my man look, he was a man, but he done her. John said, I got to do, leave you, won't be gone very long. Lord, Lord, don't wait up on me, honey, worry while I'm gone. He was a man, but he done her. Frankie went down on South Street, get her a stein of beer. Asked that big fat pretender, had my man's in the air. He was my man, but he done her. In the hotel, up in the window so high, that she saw her loving man, loving that Nelly fly. He was a man, but he done her. Johnny saw Frankie her coming, down the back stairs of his school. Lord, Lord, he pulled the pistol, the gun went Rudy too. He was a man, but he done her. Roll me over easy, baby, roll me over slow. Lord, Lord, roll me on my right side, left side hurt me so. He was a man, but he done her. Bring out your old time hearse, bring out your old time hat. Lord, Lord, 12 men going to the graveyard, never coming back. He was a man, but he done her.
Say 12 men going to the graveyard, 11 men coming back. I like that part. Blues time. Keeping traditional.
Have you ever been walking down a lonesome road? walking, baby, walking down a lonesome road. Ah, no place to go. Ooh, Lord, no place to room and board. Things look so dark, baby, down that road ahead. Things look so dark, baby, down that road ahead. Now, when you get to thinking about no place to live, no, then listen to what your mother said. Things are so lonesome when you ain't got a shelter up over your head. Things look so lonesome when you ain't got a shelter up over your head. Yeah, when you could have been at home, ooh, Lord, sleeping in a feather bed. The road is so lonesome when you're traveling all alone. So lonesome when you're traveling all alone. Now, when all you got, ooh, Lord, out of clan, this world is dead and gone.
What in the world is you waiting on? I've got another mama, she ain't long in old town. I say I got another mama, she ain't long in old town. But to tell you the truth, man, she's soft as a butterball. Every movement from her head down to her toe. She got every movement from her head down to her toe. And she can break in on a dollar, man, most anywhere she goes. She was my best mama, but she would treat me right. I said she was my best mama, but she would treat me right. She wouldn't do nothing but bad house all night long.
I get along without you. Except perhaps in spring, but I should never think of spring, how that would surely break my heart in two.
Miss Billie Holiday, I get along without you very well.
Frightened arms, polka dots. sunset moonbeam sparkled on a pug-nosed dream. There were questions.
You done the right thing. I want to thank you too. Now let's have a little drink. Just me and you. I don't care what the people are thinking. I ain't drunk. I'm just drinking.
But you're so high.
Who, me? I ain't high, man.
But you're so high.
Why y'all talk about me like this?
But you're so high.
You gotta mind your own business,
all the time.
You gotta watch yourself, too, if you don't understand what I'm saying. I wanna tip you, baby, before I go. I'll be back tomorrow night and drink some more. I don't care what the people are thinking. I ain't drunk. I'm just drinking.
But you're so high.
Oh, no, you the one drunk. Look at your eyes, man.
But you're so high.
Don't you tell my lady now. Well, I ain't here
but so
four, five, six,
seven,
Albert Collins said something about I ain't drunk, neither am I. Somebody called it was drunk. They were wondering if we were broadcasting the minister's speech, and I told him I didn't know. Well, ain't you got it? No, I ain't got nothing around here to say, and I don't know anybody to know. He couldn't figure that out. Maybe he was drunk. Monday through Friday is when we staff the station fully, and we answer all the questions about what was played on Tuesday and on Friday. But those of us who weren't privileged to have listened, we might have had to work or sleep or something. We don't really know. But if you want to hear something repeated, the best time, we usually have the same guys here on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So if you call during the time you heard it, it's a good chance that that guy might remember it. We can't tell, though. It's 11:04. My name is Washington. They call me the Bama. It's raining outside and long nights make long days. And I think this is going to be a pretty good lengthy one.
Drag on, drag on. folks and watch folks sound, that everybody's gonna jam. Just take this boxcar Joe, we got sawdust on the floor. Tell Peggy Caroline Dine, we're gonna have a heck of a time. And when the bitch said feel the air, there'll be substance everywhere. We gonna pitch a wing gang doodle all night long.
Leaving her old man. He done called me, he upset. I sure can't blame her for being upset, boy. Let me tell you what this idiot did. He thought she was going shopping most of the day. I guess she got back too soon for him, 'cause she saw the car when it pulled away. Whatever that woman been putting on him, Lord, it must have been mighty strong for that fool to have the nerve to bring some woman into their home. He tried to tell her she was an evil lady who just happened by, as she was selling some new perfume that she wanted his wife to try. His stupidity was a crime. Lord, he spent his life in jail. He didn't even have enough common sense to take the woman to a motel. So she told him, put your rags in a brown paper bag, go on and hit the door.
Go on.
Let the knob hit you in the back, Jack. I don't ever want to see you no more.
Hit you in the back, Jack.
Ain't no use to looking pitiful or trying to explain. A little taste of our sadness has blown your whole thing. Yes, it has. A little taste of our sadness has blown your whole thing. Tried to show him the light, but you know what? You can come for the snake, but he's still gonna bite. He laid on her weakness, what really turned her on. She should have put him out a little bit sooner, but his love must have been too strong. But even a dog will get tired if you keep on doing him wrong. He won't even come to you if you offer him his favorite bone. So she told him, put your rags in a brown paper bag, go on and hit the door.
Go on.
Let the knob hit you in the back, Jack, 'cause I don't ever want to see you anymore.
Hit you in the back, Jack.
So ain't no use to looking pitiful or trying to explain. A little taste of our sadness has blown whole thing. Yes, it did. A little taste of outside living has blown his whole thing.
You know, they call them peaches when I was home. Georgia peaches. Miller Jackson is from down in Georgia, Donaldsonville or something like that. I don't remember. But I was just thinking, you know, playing a Miller Jackson record on the air is sort of living dangerously, especially if you haven't previewed the record. Said outside thing, I was just looking for If You're Not Back in Love by Monday, or If Loving You Is Wrong. See, I think I'll try this. It says outside thing. You get a little adventurous sometime. But we don't want to bring a good thing to an end. So let me see what I can do from this end of the board with that in mind.
Your mama and daddy say it's a shame, it's a downright disgrace. But long as I got you by my side, your people say. My friends tell me it's no future in love and a married man. If I can't see you when I want, I'll have to see you when I can. If loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right. If loving you is so wrong, baby, I don't want to be right. Am I wrong to fall so deeply in love with you? When you have a wife and two little children depending on you too. Am I wrong to hunger for the gentleness of your touch? Lord, when you have someone else at home who needs you just as much. Am I wrong to give my love to a married man? And am I wrong for trying to hold on to the best thing I ever had? If loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right. If loving you is wrong, if loving you is so wrong, I don't want to be right. If loving you is wrong, baby, I just can't be right. Wow, I don't want to be right. No, baby, I don't want to be right. You see, the terrible thing about being in love with a married man is the fact that you can't see him when you really want to, and that can get to you sometimes. Late in the midnight hour, when you really feel like you need a little love and the man ain't nowhere around, and that can get to you sometimes. When you really feel like you need someone to hold on to, the man ain't nowhere around, and that can really get to you sometime. But what gets to you most of all is when the holidays roll around. You gotta always be by yourself, 'cause that's the time when the families get together. All the in-laws come to visit, so he has to stay home and play the part of the good and faithful husband. But I ain't worried about it, 'cause I found out that when a man starts tipping away from home, somebody at home is falling down on the home front. That's because when these women marry these men, they have a tendency to take advantage of them. They forget about all the sweet things they say to get them, that they have to keep on saying them to keep them. 'Cause you got a whole lot of women out there these days, just like me, who'll tell a man anything in the world he feel like he might wanna hear. I know, 'cause I'm going with a married man. And last New Year's Eve, I was lonesome as a Mickey Ficker. But J1, the man came on in like he was supposed to. And I didn't mind waiting that one day,
'cause anything worth having is worth waiting on. So when the man came in, J1, I was right there waiting on him to tell him all them sweet things I know his wife hadn't told him over the holidays. And you can think of a whole lot of good stuff to tell a nigga when you're by yourself. So the minute my man came in the door, J1, I started laying it on him. I said, ooh, baby. Ooh, baby. Ooh, baby. My baby. You the sweetest thing I know. Yes, you are. Rainbows glow, yes you do, baby. There ain't no power, no power, no power on this earth to ever hold on, separate us, baby. 'Cause you are my You know, I don't want to leave you with a one-sided conception over this thing. Anyone out there in my shoes this evening, I want you to know what I'm talking about. I want you to know that there's two sides to this thing. There's a good side to being in love with a married man. And I like it. 'Cause you see, when you're going with a married man, he can come over two or three times and we can give you a little bit. That means you're two up on the wife already, 'cause once you marry one, you don't get it but once a week. Another sweet thing is, on payday, he can come over and give you a little bread, and I like that. But the sweetest thing about the whole situation is the fact that when you go to the laundromat, you don't have to wash nobody's funky drawers but your own. And I like it like that. I want to keep my situation just the way it is. And to make sure it stays like that, when my man come over them two or three times a week to give me my piece, I set the clock so he can get up and go home on time. Don't want him to be late.
I wonder what I'd do any better with Denise LaSalle. I don't know, we haven't crossed the border, but we're getting a little close for my taste.
There's so much alike.
Let's do this and go.
One is just as ridiculous as the other one. But in their own way, I think they love each other. Or they wouldn't have been together this long. Besides, there's just too much at stake. They are the kids, and they haven't bothered anyone. So I just told them, you can call Mrs. Johnson to keep the kids for a day or two. Take the early flight to Florida. Just the way you used to do. Have room service, bring the breakfast. Make love all through the day. If you're not back in love by Monday, then you go separate way. And if you're not back in love by Monday,
just go your separate way. Sound and name. Get the corner by the window. Tell him you love him once again. If the disco DJ's still there, go on dance till the break of day.
He said, hey man, say, you know who this is? I said, I know who it used to be. I ain't seen you in so long. He said, play that for my old lady. I said, I got something better than that to play for her. He said, well, she I said, she did what? I don't see how she stayed that long. Everybody in the neighborhood laughing at her, and she good woman, working hard, bringing the money home every day, and got to put up with you. Boss, ain't no way. You was on a desert island, and you was the only man there. I think I just have to drown you and do without. I'm gonna play something else for you, old lady. In the meantime, we'll play this for you and the ladies over at the bank, the National Bank of Washington, over on Martin Luther King Avenue.
When I found out my key, no longer fit my lock, she said, oh, baby, you can go back where you be. Hold on. See, you've been stepping out. Now someone else. No one else was at home. Oh, baby,
say, this reminded me, yesterday we went over to play Pinochle, and I got to get in touch with Dunlap and see if he want to rent that shed out there by his house, because the fellow that usually hosts the game said that he didn't have a key. He used to have a key, because he didn't use it very much, and he's always on the go. So I guess, as Louis Jordan say, she got a mean black snake, and he can't go down no more. Somebody done changed his lock. Oh, of course, I shouldn't be laughing, because since, you know, all of us were there, she allowed us to come in. And my man, he couldn't say nothing but nice things to her, but he beat the whatever out of us, because he took it out on us in that game. Maybe I better watch out. Here's another one for the ladies over at the bank. They are nice ladies. I never do overdraw that account. It has to be them.
Good morning, darling. Last night we had a good time, but we got to hurry, baby. There's a bus leaving tonight. It's hard to break away, cause your love is so strong. But I got a phone call to make to my woman at home. What I'm gonna tell her, what I'm gonna say, how can I tell her I'm leaving with you today. What I'm gonna tell her, how she gonna feel when I tell her I got another one and I'm going somewhere else to live. So hurry up and dress up, but don't take too long. I got to catch my woman before she leaves home. I wonder how she's gonna take it after loving me all these years. Will she wish me the best, or will she break down in tears? What I'm gonna tell her, what I'm gonna say, how can I tell her I'm leaving with you today? What I'm gonna tell her, how she gonna feel when I tell her I got another one and I'm going somewhere. When we started, that things would get out of hand. I'm leaving my woman broken hearted, and I know she won't understand. What I'm gonna tell her, what I'm gonna say, how can I tell her that I'm leaving with you today? What I'm gonna tell her, how she gonna feel when I tell her I got another one and I'm going somewhere else to live? Oh,
what am I gonna tell
her? What I'm gonna say? Oh,
how can I tell her?
Oh, that I'm leaving with you today.
I know the feeling. I said, well, I don't care how you add it up, it don't come out right. The downfall of too many good men is the upkeep of too many women. And as my kids grow up, they are young ladies now, they have all the money or I might have to go back to work. So I thought it over and I said, well, being a good father, I can see my way to go ahead and give up the high life, because I've been around the block a couple of times, and I don't think I got one good trip left in me anyway. So as Mom's Mabel used to say, if you can't make it, don't fake it. Let somebody else take it. So I told Denise, I said, why don't we go to dinner over here at the place where we used to eat? You know, it's a Chinese joint we used to frequent and be fond of. And we just sat down and wasn't nothing planned. And that's good, because then nothing happened the way I planned it. I just reached in my pocket and gave her $200 more. I said, if you need anything else, call me, because I just can't see you being without it. And somebody got nerve enough to say, I'm buying my way. Don't you think I know it? And I ain't short on the payments either. That's the reason I got what I got. And if you ain't buying, that's the reason you got what you got. For David, or with the post office there.
Away from me. So you see, a shallow victory. But just the biggest fool.
But just the biggest fool.
I was not the best woman. But just the biggest fool.
But just the biggest fool.
Whenever you apply the pressure, he would run straight to me. Anything that you but just the biggest fool.
But just the biggest fool.
I was not the best woman. But just the biggest fool.
But just the
Denise LaSalle, I was not the best woman. Says right here, in the community, we are having an affair. A Labor Day reunion at Pigfoot Bill's, or Miss Fanny Harris and her husband, Bill. A family affair, jazz and blues, Charlie Bird, Bill Harris, Milton Smith, and a whole lot of others. It was written by hand, and I can't read it, but I could read those three names. It says, picnic, bring your basket. So I guess you, boy, if it wasn't for the FCC, I could do a lot with that. Monday, September the 7th, from 3:30 p.m. until dusk. Now, I wonder what is that. I saw Nap turning here a few minutes ago. I wished I could have caught up with him. We could break down some of these terms. If maybe if Snooks get out on this, you know, early release thing. He went back up for a little rejuvenation. He was out for about 9 months, and then he decided he'd be Snooks again. He's destroying private property. Now, he ain't mugging nobody. He ain't selling no dope. Snooks is just, I believe Snooks ought to be over with Captain Mark over there at St. Eve's, because is a fella going to stay in jail as much as he does and then go back on little bull, little oddball activities destroying public property? I sure wish I'd get down there and see him. I hit him side. All that trouble it took for us to get him out of there. I remember now, that's this Pigfoot thing on Labor Day. That's the 7th of September from 3:30 p.m. until dusk. D-U-S-K. Wonder who is she? 783-6029 for more information about the ticket. But I do know it's over there near 20th and Rhode Island Northeast. It's on Hamlin Street. It's 2021. That 2021 might get us all something if we can get down to the legal place where we can put $2 or $3 on it, because that's contributing to the public schools and all, because the money that's left over from paying out all the lottery, you know, puts computers in the school. I know who takes the computers out, but we don't want to even get into that. That's Big Mo's job, Maurice. Bates Area Civic Association and the D.C. Commission on Public Health sponsors the Unity in the Community Day. Unity in the Community. I could probably do a lot with that, too, if I had a chance, but Family and Friends Building a Healthier Community. Saturday, August the 29th, from noon until 6 p.m. at Armstrong/Dunbar High School Sports Complex, First and Peace Streets. So it's supported in part by the D.C. Committee to Promote Washington. I wonder what that mean. They ain't brought nothing by, so I guess not. That probably mean Washington, D.C. They can always trick me into reading something if I think that my name is on it. What else we got here? See, we are doing public service. You know it's raining. Bama doing public service. Special attractions, jazz, gospel, Bowling Green John, and Bowling Green John Cephas and Phil Wiggins, some reggae music, Mary Jefferson, the Everyday Theater, Benning Heights Gospel Chorus, Buck Hill, that's Mr. Buck the mailman. I remember in the good days, Mr. Buck had that regular mail route, but he'd slip that half pint up on the stage and play for a while. Didn't make no difference who came to town. Mr. Buck had heard about him, but he didn't bother anybody. The Rap Incorporated will be there. D.C. Double Dutch Team, Lady Byron. That was a gentleman who just had a birthday, Julie Moore's husband, Carl. He will also be over there on Bates Street. And if Carl and Julie be there, me and Denise will be there. Bring your picnic baskets. Well, I'm on a diet. I'll just bring what I want to eat. We leave that alone, because that can be stretched out into a whole lot of things. So many things you can't do now. It ain't much fun being on the radio. And it is possible to be entertaining and risque without being vulgar. See, just leave it up to the individual. And if he can't hack it, put him, if he's in the wrong field, put him in the other field. But don't put a set of boxing gloves on the dude and tell him to go pick a bale of cotton. I think it would be difficult. Now, there are some who might find it possible, especially if they went to Columbia University and used to play with the Redskins and wear number 74. I wouldn't be surprised at what Big George couldn't do. He is an entrepreneur. The only somebody I know that went to Columbia University that listens to us.
my mouth. You even went down, girl, said if I was your house. That's why I love you. Wanna hold you in my arms. Wanna squeeze you tight, girl. Turn on all my charm. You are my world and joy, girl. So I ain't gonna leave you, I ain't gonna never leave you. So I wanna hold you, squeeze you tight.
That's Lil Ed and Blues Imperials. Lil Ed's uncle, I'm trying to think of his name. He did a thing called Hulk Squat. He did Summertime. The first blues show I ever saw through its entirety was here in Washington out at the Fort DuPont area. And this guy headlined the bill. He's going to sing in the Heavenly Choir now. But he had a slide guitar, and the little fellow could play. J.B. Huddle, that's who it is. That was J.B.'s nephew, who's trying to carry on the tradition, but I think he got a little more work to do before he can get around to J.B.'s level, because the little fellow could do it all. With them high heel boots on, must have been at least 4 feet tall off the stage and 9 feet tall on it.